William the Conqueror ship supplies from here during his conquest of England. Selma de Champlain sets sail from here to establish Canada. Some historians consider this the birthplace of Impressionist art. And we were impressed with its 15th century bell tower, prison street, and half-timbered architecture. It truly is an authentic journey back in time. Hi, I'm Jim Haswell. Join Mavis and I as we toured the medieval port town of Honfleur, and I'll share some of its amazing history. We start with the picturesque harbor, then check out an awesome old wooden bell tower and the Church of St. Catherine. We wander down beautiful cobblestone lanes with assorted shops and restaurants, and check out the last remaining harbor gatehouse with a monument to Selma de Champlain. On the way back, we stumble across a secluded back street with even more amazing wood-timbered buildings. We stroll around its lively after-dark scene, and then we wrap with a memorable view of its harbor buildings in the morning sun. The Seine River flows through Paris, emptying into the English Channel by Honfleur, making this an ideal port for more than 1,000 years. In the 8th century, Vikings settled in the region, and they traveled down the Seine, raiding villages and monasteries, including Paris, until the King of France granted them what would become Normandy in exchange for ceasing their raids and providing support to the king. William the Conqueror had supplies shipped from here to aid his conquest of England in 1066. Honfleur then bounced between English and French control a few times until the French reclaimed it for good in 1449 during the Hundred Years' War. And for the next 300 years, it prospered from trade with North America and Asia until Le Havre across the bay became the region's primary port. Honfleur fortunately escaped the bombs of World War II, and today it offers a romantic port enclosed on three sides by sprawling outdoor cafes, tiny streets with architecture dating back to the 14th century, many with a half-timbered style. This unique Church of St. Catherine is the largest wooden church in France, and it's one of its oldest. Built in 1468 after the end of the Hundred Years' War, it's 550 years old. Built by shipbuilders of the day, its ceiling is like the upside-down hulls of two wooden ships. History has it that in the last months of World War II, a bomb fell through the roof but didn't explode. We now check out what I was so eager to see. Nothing looks more medieval than this cool-looking bell tower. Its five bronze bells were too heavy for the wooden church, so a separate tower was built, made of sturdy oak construction, and erected above a stone and wood-timbered house where the bell ringer lived. It was also the subject of one of Monet's paintings. Some art historians consider Honfleur as the birthplace of Impressionist art. Just down the street is a museum dedicated to Eugène Baudin, who grew up and painted here. At 30, he met a teenage Claude Monet, who lived across the bay at Le Havre. both liked to paint outdoors, which was unorthodox to the times. Baudin persuaded Monet to become a landscape painter, encouraging a love of bright hues and the play of light on the water. Baudin hosted painting sessions, inviting Monet and other early Impressionist painters, and they also taught Baudin their technique of building a subject with multiple brushstrokes of colors. In 1823, Baudin joined them at the revolutionary first Impressionist exhibition in Paris. Monet and Baudin remained lifelong friends, and Monet later paid tribute to Baudin's early influence on his work. We now come out at the entry to the harbor. During the Hundred Years' War, the harbor was fortified by a big wall and twin gatehouses. This building is one of the gatehouses and all that remains of the town's fortification. In the 17th century, it was the residence of the king's lieutenant. On the wall is a monument to Samuel de Champlain. Jacques Cartier founded Canada in 1534, but it was 74 years later, in 1608, that Samuel de Champlain set sail out of this harbor with three ships and a local crew to establish Quebec. Yeah, let's go in there. Which was a good choice, because we stumble across a most memorable street. Oh, isn't that awesome? In two adjacent 16th century buildings, one was a prison, the other a manor house, and now they're the Museum of Ethnography and Popular Art. Here's Honfleur's oldest building, dating back to 1369. Originally a church, it's now the town's maritime museum. Before we leave town, I make a quick run to the harbor for some beautiful early morning shots. Notice the sun on those neat jagged top buildings and the awesome reflections in the water. I'll always remember this view. Now for a quick preview of our next episode. In historic Bayeux, an impressive 230-foot-long medieval tapestry depicts the events leading up to the Norman conquest of England. Experience the essence of that story, along with a magnificent display of 17th-century lace and the Notre Dame Cathedral and Crypt.